Listen, how many of you in the house, you are able to easily talk to my photograph, play with it, feed, do all the game, but when you come in front of me, you feel intimidated. You feel I am too heavy, raise your hand. So this is the reason Atmamurti is your own personal version of Nityananda, who is only owned by you, who talks only to you, only about your problems. He doesn't care about anybody else's problems. He doesn't try to do some mediation thing. When you say, hey, finish him, he goes and finishes him. When you say, do this, he goes and does this. When you say, eat, and he eats. I understand. It is like a, see, the in the spiritual journey, the first step is divine in the mold you want, then you and divine, and you in the mold the divine wants. The Visishta Dvaita, Visishta Advaita, Advaita. So in the first level, for the game of Dvaita, divine in the mold you want, Atmamurti is a big support. Then you will just have the space of you and divine. That is Visishta Advaita. Then suddenly you will see, without even your knowledge, you are in the mold the way divine wants. So it's a beautiful step rolling into the Advaita. That is the reason the Atmamurti is given. Atmamurti is the unique concept of Hinduism. Without the intimidation of the too big, experiencing the divine in a personal space. Experiencing the divine in your personal space without the intimidation of Vishwarupa. Understand? Krishna was always Atmamurti for Arjuna. That is why he could not handle Vishwarupa. But that does not mean he did not become enlightened. After the war, everything, he said, come on, now I am ready to have the Vishwarupa. Let me see once more. He sees once more. That is called Anugita. He sees once more. And finally, he himself becomes part of Krishna and gets enlightened. So understand, Atmamurti is a beautiful initial way of starting the divine you game, the you me game, and I you, that game. And by you will see that it raises you to the next level and ultimately Advaita.